I think we can start now. And before I welcome you again, let me drive your attention to some changes in the program, which is inside the program you got. The last session, we had 5 or 6 cancellations, last minute cancellations. So the last session of Sunday, tomorrow, has been deleted, and the speakers have moved to other sessions today and tomorrow. In the last session today, session 4, Michael Woods in session 5 tomorrow morning, and Judy McGilbrick is in session 8, minor adaptation of the original program. However, you have to think over who is going to replace Jean Hillier, who was discussed in session 2 and session 6. Session 2 is theory and session 6 is urban issues. Just think over it. We can ask Manuel for the next session to be a discussion. And there's somebody closer to urban issues for session 6. We are 20 minutes late, so everything will move ahead. But we will make it by the end of the day today. So, first of all, let me welcome you. I was ill today, in Greek. It's not Greek to you now. Thank you, all of you, for all of you to come to this symposium and present your work. And special thanks to Manuel, who accepted the invitation to be a central speaker, because everybody here uses his work, including me. I thank all of the rest of people who are here who came to attend the symposium. I'm very happy that eventually we will have a good representation, 3 continents, Oceania, Europe, America, 6 countries, there were 8, but the cancellation brought 8 down to 6. We have a wide range of ages from 18 months to 16. And expertise, it's a very good assemblage, representative of the wide diffusion of the idea and assemblage thinking. Now, I will tell you a few words of introduction, how the idea of this symposium emerged and the symposium was assembled. While I was studying human responses to land aggregation, I felt that something was wrong with the ontology underlying human environment, or socio-ecological studies in general. My object of reference, human responses, exhibited a wide range of actualization spanning the formal and informal spectrum. It could not be simply reduced to specific responses like administrative measures, policy, land management, economic measures, because empirical applications concern specific responses in specific places at specific times. Now, there exist and are still in use various disciplinary conceptualization theories, models, and empirical studies of socio-environmental phenomena, together with the post-1970s interdisciplinary endeavors within the sustainability discourse and the recent companion resilient thinking. Now, interdisciplinary endeavors share common concepts. Socio-ecological problems are complex and rooted, hence requiring non-linear approaches. This is almost common sense now. Complex interaction exists between the material, natural resources, human artifacts in the immaterial economy society cultural component of the social ecological system. Context matters, uncertainty prevails, and adaptive management and co-management in governance are required to maintain the socio-ecological resilience of these systems and achieve progress towards sustainable development. Surprisingly, the prevailing implicit or explicit ontology underlying socio-ecological studies still remains in an ontology of systems as a whole, and positivism reigns supreme in or post-positivism, in treating human and non-human components and their relationships. No wonder when I encountered the assemblage in literature in 2012, I was convinced that the non-reductionist and the relational assemblage was the ontology of complex systems, or more correctly, multiplicity comprising assemblages, multitudinous assemblages. And the study of socio-ecological and other complex problems, such as human responses to land migration, might be better framed by assembly thinking. The theoretical and empirical works employing assembly ontology analytic are firmly grounded and include the seminal work of Division Vitali, who encouraged, however, multiple readings and interpretations of their ideas, and of course, Manuel de Lander. Commendable down-to-earth, clear and digestible translation of their often obscure, guarded and idiosyncratic text, as well as his personal contribution. Despite the enthusiastic uptake in academic circles, the dedicated meetings organized and the insightful application in many and diverse fields, assembly thinking has not diffused yet as widely as it should to make an impact on the outlook, approaches, and study of complex problems, and on the management recommendations offered. Thus, the idea of assembling a multidisciplinary international symposium group of scholars engaging in assembly-related work to reflect on conceptual, theoretical, methodological, empirical, and policy governance issues to present their research and outline an agenda for the future, naturally immersed, and this symposium came into being. Now, I'm using assembly thinking as it is currently the trend, instead of assembly theory, because assembly theory has, in my opinion, a more circumscribed and precise meaning, where theory focuses on a specific object of interest, assembly in this case, making assumptions about ontology and proposing how to systematically describe, explain, predict with any degree of certainty the structure and dynamics. While assembly thinking is broader and more encompassing, like resilient thinking, complexity thinking, and so on. It refers to a mode of relational thinking, including both ontology and theory, a way of approaching an object of interest, not as a pre-existing whole and essence, but as emerging from the coming together of heterogeneous, coexisting and co-functioning components that create agency and assembly. Diverse scientific fields, you already know, and thematic areas have historically applied and contemporaneously employ the assemblage ontology, like philosophy, arts, architecture, natural sciences, social sciences, geography, through to informatics, management, planning, and governance. Several of them are represented in this symposium. The diverse applications of assemblage thinking reflect alternative readings and supports Anderson and McFarlane's proposition that assemblage is used as a descriptor, a concept, and effort. Assemblage-related, continuously produced research exhibit shared premises, the assumption of human reality, the rejection of essentialist taxonomies, binaries, and of clear boundaries among categories, a processual view of phenomena as multiplicities that emphasizes praxis and habits, the habitual practices and mechanisms through which components get assembled, but also those that disassemble them, the emergent multiple actualizations of phenomena, a renewed and deeper emphasis on the materiality of objects of study, even in fields where the material was traditionally present, such as architecture, geography, human environment studies. It lacked non-hierarchical ontology that overcomes the micro-macro division. So assembled thinking implies a radical change of outlook and attitude toward the world. It captures the continuous unfolding of real-world phenomena, and thus it advances a vibrant object of reference for theoretical studies and empirical application, and asks researchers to renegotiate taken for granted conceptual, theoretical, methodological, and governance issues. My hope and expectation is that this symposium will be one of those small acts that will bring about a big change to demonstrate the suitability of assembled thinking to ontologically frame the study and governance of complex issues, to indicate how to make it operational and accessible to a broader audience for academic and practical purposes, and eventually to answer the question of this symposium: could assembled thinking serve as a suitable template or paradigm for the study of socio-spatial and other complex issues? Thank you. And now, Manuel will tell us more.